Hi friends, let's solve the problem on IRR today. The theory of IRR and NPV is explained in a separate video. We'll solve the problem directly. IRR is that discount rate at which NPV is equals to zero. Now what is discount rate? It can be the cost of funds or the market rate. So let's look at the problem. I plan to invest ₹1,000 in the machine which will fetch me ₹400 per year in next 4 years. Means today I am investing 1000 and I will be getting 400 per year for next 4 years. Discount rate is 12%, means cost of funds is 12%. I have to calculate the IRR and suggest if I have to invest or no. Now IRR I have told you earlier, but that also means the returns which I will be getting in the project, means percentage of returns which I will be getting in the project. So let's solve this. You can go through my NPV video for getting these details. First we have to find out the NPV with 12% discounting rate which is given. In the year 0 I am spending the money ₹1000, from year 1 I am getting 400 each year. So I have to find out the discounting factor first. 1 upon 1 plus this 0.12 raised to 0, because first year it comes out to be 1, then raised to 1, 2, 3, 4, and then you get the present value of this 400. And you can see as you go higher the present value decreases. So after getting this present value we add it up and subtract it from 1000. So net present value we get. Net present value means total, means what I have spent and what I have got. The total of that comes out to be 213. Now discount, when the discount rate is 12, my NPV is 213. I have to find out that discount rate X where NPV will be equals to 0. So this is a trial and error method. Now so let's try with another value of discounting rate. Let's try with, here there is a trick to get this. Try always with more than double value. So 12 to the 24 and add 1, means add 1 or round it off to the next 5, so it comes out to be 25. So we'll try with 25. We'll have to solve this again with 25. So let's solve this with 25 now. Again the same thing, 0 year 1000 gone, 400 coming in for next 4 years. Now I'm solving it with 0.25. This raised to 1, 2, 3, 4, and we get the discounting factor again. You can check this discounting factor calculation in my NPV video. So then we multiply this discounting factor A, D by A, and if we get the present value of this 400 rupees. Then we again find out the net present value, means subtract this total from this 1000 and we get minus 55.36. So now we have got a table where 12% is 213 NPV, 25 is minus 55.36. So we have to find out the middle value. Always remember this, take more than double, then there is a fair chance of that you will be getting the answer. Always this should be less than the zero, the second value, so it becomes easier. Now follow as I am doing. Do 12 minus X, this minus this, equal upon 213 minus 0, 213 minus 0 equals to X minus 25 upon 0 minus minus 55.36. look at this. Okay, so we get 12 minus X upon 213 equals to X minus 25 upon 55.36, then cross multiply and solve all this and you will be getting the X. Now what does this mean, X? This means the total returns which I am getting from the project is 22.31. So my cost of funds is 12% given in the problem and returns which I am getting is 22.31, so I can invest. This is the way we solve the IRR problem. Always we can invest up to the time we get 22.3, means if my cost of funds would have been even 20%, I would have been able to invest because I am getting more than that. So this is the way we solve the IRR problems. You can check out for other videos as well as other question bank with explanations on this site. You can download this app to get all the videos and question banks. Thanks.